So, jump below. Those right here. Attaches this to this little rod. Slip it over. Slide it back. Two screws. I could have took that rubber hose off, I don't know why I didn't. Take 3/4 inch. Tighten up a bit. And the wrench you'll need to take the carburetor off your engine is 7/16. 4 bolts. Every corner. There's that. Now we can put on the top. Yeah, let's put on the top. So we get our gasket. Make sure all the holes line up. Now, double check, make sure you did everything right. This linkage slides through the little corner. Line the gasket up. Lined up for 6 bolts, drop them in the holes. Screwdriver and screw. When you're doing this, you'll want to alternate your turning in a star pattern just to make your gasket sit properly. There's that. I'll hook up the linkage right here. Got this little guy. It's going to sit under here. First, you got to turn on that funny angle. Hook him up that. Tiny little screw. It sits right there. Turn. See the linkage working. Okay. Now I'll put these guys in. Radio control screws. Finger turn them in. Bigger screwdriver. Turn them in until you feel it sit. not too tight. I don't want to damage your carburetor. It's sitting there. I'll turn it out half, one, one and a half, two, two and a half. There's my setting point. Screw in the other one. Set. So two and a half out. Half, one, half, two, half. Those are in. Now let's move this part. So put your spring in that way. This in that way. Gasket. This is probably the trickiest part I found on it. And it's just because you gotta push it down, line your gasket up as your spring is compressed. Four screws. What did I use on that? I believe I used flatheads. Once you got one tight, you can sort of take your hand off it.